My name is Pastor Chris Aaron Rice, and I'm here at the Veterans Coming Home Center, New Life Evangelistic Center's Day Center in Springfield, Missouri. There are so many people in the city of Springfield who are really struggling in a season of despair and hopelessness, and they've got obstacles that are really serious. One of those obstacles is not being able to transport yourself easily around the city of Springfield. Springfield is a very spread out city, and public transportation is the only way that many rely to get from one place to another. And even with that public transportation, it still takes hours for them to get to one end of the city to the other. And they need transportation to get to doctor's appointments. They need transportation to get to housing authorities to apply for housing or to get to a job interview and apply for employment. They really need transportation to get these critical things done because it's very hard to walk miles and miles after getting very little sleep, carrying all the stuff that you own on your back. It's very difficult to walk all over the city of Springfield. And New Life Evangelistic Center provides this public transportation assistance in the form of bus tickets. And when you partner alongside New Life, you make a big difference in the lives of so many by helping them get to where they need to go and give them a little hope in tangible, practical ways. And so we thank all of our partners who are supporting New Life financially so that we can buy these bus tickets and get them into the hands of people who need them most. Now let's talk to some people who really need this assistance, and you can hear their stories firsthand.
In Joshua 1:9, it says, "Be bold, be brave, don't be dismayed, don't be afraid, because the Lord thy God is with you." I'm joined here with Jeffrey. And Jeffrey, that's one of your favorite scriptures.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What did you have to be bold and be brave about?
I was out on the street and I had nowhere to go, and I'd never been in that situation before, so I didn't know what to do.
Okay. Let's back up a little bit. How did you get in this situation?
I was arrested for failure to pay child support. It was in Clay County, Missouri, North Kansas City, and they held me for over 60 days. So I was unable to pay any bills or get a hold of anyone, and I lost everything while I was in there.
Okay. Name me some of the things you lost.
I lost my place to live, my car, my job, my bank account, my phone.
Your whole wallet, your ID, everything.
Everything, right. Yeah.
So you came out basically with nothing.
I had God.
Ah, I like that. I love hearing that. Repeat that again. You had what? I said you had nothing, and you said what?
I had God.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
We always have God.
We always have God.
He never goes.
He never goes. It's just acknowledging Him, mm-hmm. Right? You are learning how to love again.
Correct.
Right?
Yeah. I'm learning to embody the fruits of the Spirit.
Okay. And one of the fruits of the Spirit is love. Right? And so God is love. And so now you're learning how to finally love yourself.
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah.
Through the power of God.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, what are you doing now to get off the streets, to restore your life?
I have I've applied at several places to do the restoration program. So it'll take at least a year, if not longer.
Okay.
And I am I'm praying every single day, and it's blowing my mind.
Okay.
The amount of people that God puts in my life that I get to help, even though I'm in this situation.
Yeah. God uses everything, right? God is able to take our lemons and make lemonade. That's a real simple way of saying Genesis 50:20, which says, "What you intended for my harm," this is Joseph speaking, "what you intended for my harm, God meant for my good." Yeah. Right? So He takes all those bad things that happen in our lives, all those struggles, all the trials, tribulations, all our mistakes, all our sins, and transforms them into our good for His glory.
I am literally living that day by day right now.
I admire you for your faith and your strength in God and your love of God. I want to encourage you to keep going. Don't give up. Let Jesus lead you all the way.
Always.
Okay. Thank you.
He's my Heavenly Father. He's the only one that's ever been for me, no matter what. People will always let you down, but God never will.
That's right. That's right. Thank you, Jeffrey.
Thank you.
Scott, what are some of the things that are going on in your life that you're really thankful for? What are you grateful for right now?
Well, I found Jesus is one thing. And ever since I have found him, I've been getting all my stuff together. I got my cell phone and everything. So I'm doing very good right now. So,
yeah. Who witnessed Jesus Christ to you first?
I think I did.
So how did you find Jesus? You said that you found Jesus. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I was in Republic one night, and I was walking home, and I was very hungry. I was tired, and I asked Jesus, Lord, please give me something to eat. And out of the blue, a donut showed up. And ever since that day, I've been amazed. So.
And Jesus is really helping you in tangible, practical ways, right?
Yes.
Are you reading his word?
I try. I got a Bible and everything, so.
Yeah. So what are some of the obstacles to really breaking out of this situation in your life?
Just get off the streets and just get yourself together, you know. I got my license and everything. You know, I'm doing pretty good right now.
Is transportation a barrier? Is it hard to get around in Springfield sometimes?
The buses can be kind of full and slow, but besides that, it's all right.
Yeah. How many miles do you think you walk each day?
at least 50.
Wow. 50 miles each day.
Yeah. I walk everywhere. Yeah. So
when you can get bus tickets, it's really nice to be able to get to where you need to go without walking there, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Do we have an effective bus system here in Springfield?
Yeah, I think it's pretty good.
Really?
Yeah, it's pretty on time.
Good. And so how does the Veterans Coming Home Center help you out?
It gives you a place to relax and get off the streets to cool down, and gives you food and water and resources, you know, take showers and do the laundry here. It helps a lot.
Well, Scott, God bless you. I'm glad that you're starting to get things straightened out and that you really found Jesus. That's wonderful. He is our Lord and Savior, and he is good.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Scott.
Hi.
How are you doing today?
Pretty good.
Good. What's your first name?
Kathy.
Kathy, what's some of the things that are going on in your life right now?
Well, my son committed suicide. I have anxiety, depression, and PTSD. Plus, I have arthritis. Plus, I also have colon cancer. So,
there's a lot of things going on in your life right now.
Oh, yeah. I have an infection in my colon now, too. I went to the hospital and got antibiotics.
When did your son die?
May 27, 2020.
But it's still as if it happened really recently.
Yes. I signed up for Disability Social Security, but I haven't gotten it yet.
So,
I've been a CNA for 38 years, and I came disabled.
You were a CNA for 38 years?
Yes, I loved it.
So you are used to helping others, serving them, and practicing.
I'm not used to being the one that needs help and being homeless and all that stuff. So,
how long has this been the situation?
I've been homeless since like the first week of June.
What are some of the things that are preventing you from really getting a house and supporting yourself?
Well, I went to one door that's supposed to be helping me get an apartment and stuff like that, but it just hasn't came through yet.
Yeah. Kathy, what keeps you going? What keeps you putting one foot in front of the other?
Just got to keep the faith and smile and just be happy and just do it.
What are you putting your faith in?
God.
Is he, do you see how he's working in your life and providing for you?
Oh, yes. I see it every day.
How are these bus tickets going to help you?
Because I take the bus here, and you take the bus everywhere you go. Just you don't have to walk anymore than what you have to. Because you walk every day. Who knows how many miles you walk every day. Yeah. There's no way of knowing.
Can I pray for you?
Sure.
Heavenly Father, I lift up Kathy to you. I just pray, Lord, that you would heal her body. Lord, she has colon cancer, and that's a serious thing. Please be with her doctors. Lord, help her to focus on you and the internal inheritance that she has in Christ. Lord, help her and give her hope. Give her strength. Open doors for her to break out of this situation and to glorify you with her life. Lord, please help Kathy today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Well, we're going to help you with some bus tickets. Thank you so much for talking with us today. How are you doing today?
I'm doing pretty good.
What's pretty good in your book?
About the best you can do under circumstances.
Yeah. What are those circumstances?
You know, just being out here on the streets trying to find a job, which I think I might have found one. I'm waiting for them to call me. Yeah. Stuff like that.
Yeah. So what are some of the barriers to getting a job, keeping a job, and maintaining a job while you're experiencing homelessness?
Being able to get up, you know, not knowing actually what time it is, not having a place to sleep.
Yeah. You know, I think a lot of people don't recognize that that's even a barrier. When you're not in that situation, they can't, you know, time is even hard to tell when you don't have that place, right?
Right.
So how many jobs have you had and then unfortunately lost just because? And so these bus tickets are going to help you get to that work and all of that. What keeps you going? What gives you hope?
Will to survive.
Will to survive. You want to keep going. You want to break out of this situation, right?
Right.
How long have you been in this situation?
A couple of years. Off and on.
What's the single biggest barrier to really getting out of this situation?
Finding a job and being able to keep it.
Yeah. So if you had a job and it was a good job, a good paying job, you really think, yes, I could get into a place of my own, I could really support myself?
Yep.
Yeah.
Definitely.
What are some of the skills that you've developed over your life that you think are make you skilled at something that could make you some money?
Construction, dishwashing, just different types of things. Ain't too much I can't do.
So you've done a little bit of everything, and that makes you ready to really get back into that workforce, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, we really hope that these bus tickets help you get into that good place where you're really able to sustain yourself and eventually, right, after you've taken care of yourself, you can give back to others. Is that something you like to do as well?
Yes, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah. What's the joy of helping others?
Just feeling that you know you did something somebody else that they couldn't do.
Well, thank you so much for talking with us today, and you have a good day, okay? How are you doing?
I'm doing.
You're doing. Yeah. What are some of the circumstances that are going on right now?
Right now I am homeless. I'm living in state of sleep, and it's hard not having an ID and birth certificate, trying to get a job, and transportation is getting the best of me.
So, what are some of the unique challenges that women face here in Springfield when they're homeless?
You can't really trust everybody that you meet, but it's getting kind of like you're in your own shell, you know, you own your own. So you got to understand that even though you may not, somebody else may be in the same situation, you try to help each other along the way. Even though that person may be like, I don't want to talk to you, just try to be there for them, just like they be there for you. So that's how we're trying to keep together.
Right. So you try to follow the golden rule. Treat others as you want to be treated as much as possible.
Exactly.
What keeps you going? What gives you hope to put one foot in front of the other?
God. I pray to him every night to help me get out the situation I'm in and put me in the right path. And he's been doing that.
Yeah. Give me an example of how he's doing that.
Well, I give you an example. Yesterday, I wanted to get a cell phone, and I didn't have ID. So I went to this place called One Door. They gave me an ID, but I still couldn't get one. But the place where I'm staying at now, Safe to Sleep, they're going to get me an ID and a birth certificate, and I don't have to pay anything.
Wow, so God is helping you provide some of these critical IDs through the services here.
Let me get housing too, so. Housing and food stamps and get me a job, vocational skills, all that. So he's been awesome.
Well, we want to let you know these bus tickets are coming from the Lord as well to help you get to where you need to go, and we hope that this is a blessing to you.
It is a very good blessing for me. I appreciate it. I need them.
Thank you so much, and God bless you, okay?
Thank you so much.
All right. How are you doing today?
I'm all right. How are you doing?
Good. So what's some of the circumstances that are going on in your life
right now? Some of the circumstances going on in my life right now is my life been ruined. I've lost my my wallet, my ID, my social security card, and credit card was in there and everything like that. And my food stamp card, I lost it over by Popeyes when I worked at Popeyes. I lost my job. So it either got stolen, my wallet got stolen, or it was lost. It was like a billfold, and it zipped up, and it had a SMSU bear on it and everything like that. So, I lost that. But basically what's going good is my life is I'm doing freestyle battles around the world challenge on REP Fame, MCCTA Commerce Long Island, and I'm like ranked 25 right now out of 1,000 freestyle hip hop singers in the hip hop industry, like literally. So I'm working my way up there, you know what I mean? And, basically, yeah, that's about it. Just my life being ruined. Somebody stole my identity. You know what I mean? I've reported it to the Federal Bureau of Investigations about my ID being stolen, my Social Security card, and made a report to the police about my ID being stolen. So,
hopefully, they can find it.
Well,
soon.
If anybody tries to use it, they're using basically a nothing. You know what I'm saying? Of somebody's life that's been ruined in Springfield, Missouri.
So how does the Veterans Coming Home Center help you out in your circumstance?
Coming here helps me out by I can relax my mind. All my friends are here, you know what I mean? Most of my friends, including Escobar over there. Just coming here helps me relax my mind. I got a place to, like, lay down, you know what I'm saying? Because I sleep outside, and I only get, like, maybe, like, 4 or 5 hours of sleep a night. So basically, you know, just I can relax my mind, come here and eat food and everything like that. You know?
Well, we really hope these bus tickets help you out. Thank you so much for sharing.
Yeah, no problem.
I'm joined here with Corey, who several years ago had a stroke. And it was a massive stroke that left you unable to function.
Paralyzed my left side.
Okay. And that stopped you from working.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And so you became homeless.
About 6 months ago.
Okay. Recent.
Yeah, well, permanently homeless about 6 months ago.
Okay. How has the homeless experience been for you?
Humbling.
Okay. Why do you say humbling?
Because I don't care about material things anymore.
Okay. You've gotten closer to God since the stroke?
I read my Bible every day.
Okay. All right. So how has this place helped you?
Well, you guys get showers and laundry and food and stuff like that. Everything we really need, our basic needs.
Okay. Where would you go if this place wasn't open?
Nowhere.
Okay. We talked earlier about housing in Springfield. I want you to talk about that. What's wrong with Springfield?
There's not enough housing for the homeless people.
Okay. And you say housing, you're talking about permanent housing.
Mm-hmm. Like apartments and stuff like that.
Okay. So I know that some places in Springfield that house the homeless only do it for 6 months, right? Or sometimes 30 days and you have to go.
Yeah.
Okay. That's been your experience?
Like the only manned shelter here in Springfield is only 30 days.
Okay. So you're 30 days in, and how many days you got to be out?
Well, you're in 30 days and you have to be out 6 months.
Okay. So that has forced you to sleep on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me about that. How's that feel? How's it go? How do you go from an apartment, a bed, your own bed, your own place, to having to sleep on the ground?
It sucks. I mean, but it did really align my back, though.
Okay.
Concrete has a way of doing that.
Okay. What are you doing to get off the streets, Corey?
Oh, I'm getting ready to go see my daughter and my granddaughter, and hopefully I can stay with my daughter.
Okay. We're going to keep you in prayer, and, you know, if anything we can help you with, you let us know. That's what we're here for. We're here when people are hurting. We're here when our brothers and sisters are hurting, and we want you to be there also. Maybe you can't volunteer at New Life Evangelistic Center, Veterans Coming Home Center. Maybe you can't actually physically have the time to come in, but you can still partner with us through your donations. These donations are actually literally saving lives, and we need you to get involved. You can get involved by prayer, you can get involved by volunteering, or you can get involved by partnering. But either way, help us. Help the individuals like Corey, who wants to get off the streets. and who has hope in Jesus that it will happen. You are our hope. Our hope lies in Christ, and our hope lies in you getting activated and helping us. Right, Corey?
That's right.
Okay. I'm going to thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Anthony, what are some of the circumstances that are going on in your life right now?
I'm homeless, and times are hard right now, but I got a job, though.
That's great. Where are you working?
McDonald's in front of the mall.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. So you've got a job, but there are still other things that are preventing you from really getting out of the situation, right?
Yes. Yeah, it's hard.
How are transportation bus tickets going to help you?
It helped me a lot to get to work and back.
Yeah.
Instead of walking there every day from West Bypass.
Wow.
Yeah.
How many miles do you think you walk each day?
I'm not really sure. A lot, though. Yeah.
Well, Anthony, we hope these bus tickets are a blessing to you, and we want you to know that we're here for you, to support you, and to give you hope, to keep going. Okay? All Don't right. give up.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Anthony.
Sweet. Thank you, sir. Could you guys pray for me?
Absolutely. Absolutely. Heavenly Father, I lift up Anthony to you. I just pray that you would guide and direct him, Lord. You continue to open up doors for him. Lord, that you would keep him focused on the straight and narrow path to glorify and honor you with his life, Lord. Take these bus tickets and bless him richly with those. Lord, remind him that there is hope in Jesus Christ alone. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much, Thank Anthony.
You. What's your name?
My name is Chris.
Nice to meet you, Chris.
Nice to meet you, too.
I'm joined here with Vincent. Vincent, you are homeless right now, but you're waiting on disability to come through. And so as you're waiting for disability, you are allowed to work part-time.
Part-time, right? Yeah.
So you're looking for part-time work.
Yeah. Yeah, and the problem with that is there's not a lot of places, there's hardly any places that hire part-time. So
in Springfield. But, you know, Springfield has a lot of jobs. But you're saying that most of them are full-time. You can't work full-time and get disability, right?
Right. And the thing about it is I have to... it has to be a hand-picked job because of my anxiety is so bad that I just worked for a little over 6 months at SMC Containers out on Partnership Drive, and I kept fooling myself thinking that my anxiety is not that bad, and but. As time went on, I got to where I was dreading going to work. I wasn't completing a full day's work because of my anxiety so bad, hiding in the bathroom on breaks. So it was pretty bad. So
this is real serious.
Yes, it's very
serious. It's affecting your way of life.
Yeah, you learn to adjust to it, and the places that you go and the things that you do is controlled by your anxiety.
Yeah.
They've got me on medication for it, but...
Is that helping you?
It gets me up and moving, but as far as it helping the anxiety, not much.
Okay.
So
you're still struggling with this?
Yeah.
Can I ask you, what are you anxious about? Where's anxiety come from?
It's, they call it social anxiety.
Okay.
But a lot of it stems from a lot of failures in my life, not being able to follow through or not following through with a goal that I had set.
Mm-hmm.
And as time went on, my self-esteem was lowered. And then as time went on, my anxiety got worse. And so...
I want you to know that... God loves you.
Yes.
He has not stopped loving us. And that you're valuable in his sight. He says that you are so valuable, I've taken my hand and tattooed your image into his hand so he'll never forget us. Right? That's how important you are to Christ. A lot of times we hear the voices of doubt and worry and fear. And sometimes it's coming from the devil. Right, it could be our flesh, right? Yeah. And it could be the devil, too.
Yeah.
Right.
Figuring out which is flesh and which is the devil sometimes is tricky for me.
Yeah.
But the more I am successful, the more I'm attacked.
Yeah. Yeah, and, yeah, right.
The devil does not like me. He does not want
well,
me.
Well, if you're on the right team, if the devil doesn't like you,
That's right.
I have a target on my back because I have a cross on my back.
Right.
So it's good to be, I don't want to say it's good to be attacked, right? But in those attacks, we depend upon God for the victory.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I might just say that what you said is 100% true, and that knowing and being around people like you, for instance, is inspirational for me. Yeah. To see that and know that you're being attacked too. I know you are, you know, because the devil doesn't want us to have a relationship. He's jealous of Christ.
He is.
And he doesn't want us to be happy. So I believe that in time, as I get closer to God and as I get older, mm-hmm. and I cut out a lot of my distractions, and stay focused on God, that better things will be coming my way.
They will. I'll give you a scripture. Isaiah 26:3 that says, I will keep thee in perfect peace if you stay your mind on him. Right? That's the focus that we're supposed to keep. No matter what happens, keep your mind on Christ.
I've noticed that, and, you know, staying focused on God is where it's at, because it's just like, was it Peter that got out of the boat?
Yes.
And
he looked at the storm. He defocused.
And he slowly was going down.
Right. But when he hollered for Jesus, Jesus was right there to save him.
Right.
Right. So same for
the
you.
Distractions is the devil.
Yes, they
you
are.
Know.
They are.
So
I'm going to keep you in prayer. I want you to keep Vincent in prayer also. He is a good man, but he has issues and he has problems and he struggles just like we do. But we know the victory comes through Christ. We can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. I want to thank you for being here today, Vincent.
Thank you, Pastor Mark.
You've heard a few of the stories of many who are experiencing homelessness on the streets of Springfield, Missouri. I just want to say that this work is impossible without partners who are engaging in the work with New Life Evangelistic Center. The financial needs for running a building like this are great. It costs thousands of dollars in utilities every month, not to mention all of the needs for feeding people, men and women who are experiencing homelessness every single day. On average, we see anywhere between 150 and 250 people a day come through our doors to receive much needed assistance. And we're one of the largest day centers in all of southwestern Missouri. We provide much services like showers and a free store and lockers and access to a phone, bathrooms. We provide hygiene kits and so much more. And when you really partner with New Life, you are getting all of these much needed resources into the hands of people who need them most. You're being the hands and feet of Jesus Christ in the darkness that is in Springfield and throughout Missouri. So I want to thank our partners who are engaging in this work. It's impossible for us to provide bus tickets and food and clothing and care as we do without people like you. But go and share the message of New Life, that there is real, tangible way to help people who are experiencing homelessness. Share the message of hope, Jesus Christ, in practical ways with your friends and your family and your church and your businesses. Get them involved in the work as well. The needs are great, but our God is greater, and He is working through people like you to touch the lives of so many, like Scott and Anthony and others who are experiencing homelessness in Springfield, in St. Louis, and throughout Missouri. You can make a difference. You can truly make an impact in somebody's life by partnering with New Life Evangelistic Center. We've been doing this work for 51 years. We, Lord willing, will continue to do this work for 50 more, but we need your help at this critical time to minister to people in need in Missouri and throughout the world. Thank you so much, and God bless.